Southeast Alaska, home to tall mountains, rushing waterfalls, beautiful landscapes, and the largest temperate rainforest in the Western Hemisphere. Here, a wide variety of organisms can be found. But what carved these mountains? What allows the waterfalls to flow and the forests to grow? Why is Southeast Alaska so rich in wildlife? In this documentary, we'll explore the creation of Southeast Alaska and the wide variety of animals found there. I will be your guide, Justin Schaffner, 15 years old, aboard the National Geographic vessel Seabird, as we explore Southeast Alaska. Over 4,000 years ago, Southeast Alaska was much different than it is today. It stood underneath 4,000 feet of ice. Alaskan glaciers are the only remnants of the last ice age. A glacier is a flowing lake of ice, constantly being pushed on by gravity and the weight of its own mass. This glacier, here at Tracy's Arm, stands over a mile wide and 600 feet tall. It is carved through this landscape. Over the years, glaciers shaped the mountains by scraping against their rock faces. They used their huge mass and fallen off rocks and stones to carve through the earth. The ice at the face of this glacier, Sawyer's Glacier, is nearly 200 years old. Fallen snow is compacted and turns into ice, making the river of white behind the face. Both pressure and melting ice caused parts of this glacier to fall into the ocean, in a process known as calving. As parts of the face fall into the water, unexposed ice replaces it. The deep blue color of the ice is caused by the reflection of the sunlight reflecting through the high pressure buildups in the ice. The glaciers carve the landscape of Southeast Alaska, but they do more than just that. They offer a shelter to both birds and mammals alike. The harbor seal. Small aquatic mammals, they take shelter in these icy waters at the base of the glacier. They lay on the ice to dry off from the cold Arctic waters. The glaciers and surrounding ice fields offer these harbor seals protection from predators. One main predator of the seal is this 6-ton giant, known as the orca, or killer whale. It is the largest member of the dolphin family and can grow as long as 26 feet. There are three known species of the killer whale. The one here, known as Type B, has a large white patch on its eye and feeds mainly on harbor seals. However, due to the need to surface to breathe, the orcas stray away from the ice fields, and the seals nearby the glaciers remain safe. As the glaciers receded over the last 4,000 years, they uncovered nutrient-rich soil. This allowed for the growth of the largest temperate rainforest in the Western Hemisphere. Here, tall trees dominate the landscape, and green mosses cover the forest floor. The cold climate and harsh living conditions means less fungi and bacteria can survive here. This results in the plants taking a longer time to decompose. A fallen tree, knocked over by wind, will host other trees. It is called a nurse log. The rotting wood becomes a perfect place for other tree seeds to spread their roots. Eventually, the nurse log will rot away, and these trees will have grown around the log. In a forest full of large trees and an infestation of moss, one must look closely to see tiny budding flowers of all shapes and sizes. The forest is full of large trees and small plants, but it also offers a home and shelter to a variety of mammals and birds. some larger than others, all with unique niches and behaviors. The largest of these animals, the Alaskan state mammal, the moose. A part of the deer family, this moose feeds mainly on green plants such as pondweed. Moose are aggressive creatures once startled, but they will pay no attention to a non-threatening observer. Here, a female moose, marked by a collar for research, takes her calf to a pond. They feed in the safety of dusk. They are safe from predators such as the bear, who would not risk an attack during low lights. The moose would have the advantage in not only numbers, but their speed. The bears have poor eyesight and rely on their sense of smell. The moose would escape safely. Besides, here, in broad daylight and the summer months, this grizzly bear is feeding on a more plentiful prey, salmon. As the eggs hatch, they run downstream. The bears wait, alone or with their cub. They wait for the salmon to run. This adult grizzly will need to consume over 500 salmon just to feed itself through the summer. The bears are highly adaptive animals as well. If neither moose nor salmon is available, the brown bears will feed on berries. And if those aren't available, they will even feed on certain fungi. This cub will grow up to 1,200 pounds and must feed through the summer in order to survive the cold Alaskan winters. The bears rely heavily on salmon, and humans have gone to great lengths to protect these salmon from overfishing and losing population. Here at McAuley Salmon Hatchery in Juneau, Alaska, salmon are born and raised, starting off as eggs until they hatch. They then live in a massive holding tank with up to 20 million other infant salmon. They are fed natural food until they grow into mature salmon in an outdoor holding tank. Then, they are released down a salmon ladder. The salmon ladder mocks a real stream and feeds directly into the ocean. The salmon will then come back to this facility to breed, and their offspring go through the same journey. Besides bears, these salmon have more predators once they leave the streams and enter the ocean. The bald eagle. A large bird of prey, its sharp beak and forward-looking eyes enable it to be a predator. Here in Southeast Alaska, the wingspan of these giant birds can be over 8 feet long. The female birds can be over 25% larger than the males. They can grow up to 17 pounds. Being masters of flight, they soar the skies, looking into the water to see if there's any salmon. They will swoop down with their huge talons and snatch their prey. The bald eagle is a symbol of freedom and the national bird for the United States of America. But here in Southeast Alaska, it is just one of the many predators feeding on salmon. The sea lion. A member of the sea mammal family, it can grow up to 600 pounds. It will eat nearly 10% of its body weight during a single feeding. They feed mainly on salmon. Like the harbor seals, sea lions dry off in the sun. Each sea lion picks a spot on the rock. They're very territorial animals, and will act aggressively if their territory is threatened. In the water, sea lions are curious creatures. They approach boats and other foreign objects. They play with one another and try to steal each other's catch. But the sea lion is not the only mammal in these waters. The largest family of sea mammals, the whales, share these waters. The humpback whale, large, elegant creatures, spanning over 50 feet in length and weighing in at nearly 30 tons, these whales feed in the Arctic waters during the summer and migrate nearly 8,000 miles to the subtropics where they breed. These humpbacks feed off of krill and small fish. They come to these feeding grounds here, where currents from both the Alaskan Inside Passage and the Pacific Ocean meet. They breach the surface of the water in a process known as bubble net feeding. The whales blow bubbles towards a school of krill, and this draws them close together. Then, with sheer power, the whale emerges from the depths with its mouth wide open and shoots vertically out of the water, catching the krill. Another technique of feeding, which is a rare sighting for the northern Pacific humpbacks, is to thrash its tail on the surface of the water. This is commonly seen in the North Atlantic, but is a rare sighting for here in Southeast Alaska. The humpback whales will surface to breathe every 2 to 3 minutes, but they can hold their breath for nearly 10 minutes at a time. Here in Southeast Alaska, the humpback whale has no major predator, but as they enter breeding grounds in the subtropics, certain sharks will hunt these whales. From whales to birds, to salmon to moose, Southeast Alaska is a flourishing ecosystem. Each animal plays a major role in its own world, and each organism fulfills their own special niche. Without one, the other would not survive. Predators need their prey, and prey need their predators. And most importantly, they all need the land and seas that are provided for them. Southeast Alaska, thriving with wildlife and full of beautiful landscapes. It was once under a sheet of ice nearly 4,000 feet deep. The ice carved through the mountains, paving the way for the largest temperate rainforest in the Western Hemisphere. As the ecosystems thrive and the climate slowly changes, what does the future hold for Southeast Alaska? It remains an unknown variable in the equation of Earth, but we do know that the secrets of the future can be found by exploring Southeast Alaska.